Coding is one of the most important skills that we can learn in this day and age, but how do you actually start? There are so many resources out there and it can feel very overwhelming, so today I'm going to share with you how I would learn how to code if I could start over again. A bit about me, I only started to learn how to code at 19 when I studied computer science at university, but even so, right now as a software engineer, there are still a lot of languages that I need to learn on my own, so I'm kind of self-taught in certain languages. Speaking of self-taught, I've got a very special guest featuring in this video today, Ray, aka Techie Ray. He is a self-taught programmer and a lawyer. He'll be sharing about his self-taught journey and give some advice along the way. So let's get started. So first of all, you need to pick a programming language. If you have no idea where to start, I would recommend Python or JavaScript. Python is a powerful language which can be used for a variety of purposes such as data visualization, game development, automation, and scripting. Python is highly intuitive and reads just like English, so it's perfect for beginners. And Python was actually my first language as well. JavaScript is mainly used for web applications like websites, and with technologies like Node.js, you can even use it for server-side scripting, which means that you can build the backend of an application with it as well. If you want to get into front-end development, knowing JavaScript will make your life so much easier when you start to learn frameworks and libraries like React, Angular, and Vue. The next step is to learn the basics of the language. As a rule of thumb, you want to cover concepts like variables, data types, functions, loops, conditionals, arrays, classes, and objects. While you're studying, it's important to take notes too so that you're not just mindlessly consuming all this content. I usually take notes on Notion, however, now I'm experimenting with mind maps using XMind, the sponsor of today's video. XMind is a powerful mind mapping software that allows you to create a variety of different diagrams for different purposes. Here, I've created a mind map of programming basics. I've created it as a mind map, but I can also convert it to other diagrams like tree chart, fishbone, and tree table. You can see here that I've got a main topic called programming basics, and then all these 7 subtopics. Within each subtopic, I've got a branch for how the concept is implemented in Python and JavaScript. By laying out all these topics on one page, I can get a big picture idea of how everything fits in together and what the similarities and differences between Python and JavaScript are. XMind also has lots of handy features like boundary, where I can group related topics, summary, where I can summarize related topics, and label, where I can highlight something about a topic. If I want to elaborate on a certain point, I can also add a note. XMind supports rich text formatting, so the notes that you write here can be quite thorough. And if writing is not your thing, you could also add an audio note. You can insert pictures and mathematical equations as well. One thing I wish that XMind supported though was writing code blocks. As you can see here, I did write some code, but this is basically just text. The formatting also disappears when I switch between different diagrams. Now, if you want to see your mind map as a note outline too, you can achieve that with the outliner feature. I think this is so cool because I can also do it the reverse way, where I take notes in normal bullet point format first and then convert my notes to a mind map. If you like your notes to look all pretty and aesthetic, XMind's got you covered with their extensive library of themes and swatches. You can also change up the style of your mind map to the hand-drawn style and add stickers. Another really good study technique is to teach what you learn to others. Try to explain these concepts to a variety of people. With XMind's pitch feature, you can do just that. It even seamlessly animates the presentation for you. In terms of pricing, XMind has a free and pro plan. You can already do lots of the free plan, including making unlimited diagrams. However, if you want to unlock even more and try the pro plan, you can use the 14-day free trial coupon code in the descriptions. There are plenty of resources out there, so I encourage you to try different mediums like articles, books, videos, and see which one works best for you. And I'll also put some links in the descriptions. The goal of this step is to learn just enough to be able to build a basic project. So time box yourself to maybe say a week or 2 weeks so that you don't spend too long on this or get stuck in tutorial hell. Now that you have some basic understanding of the language, it's time for you to write some code. You'll need a code editor for this, and I recommend Visual Studio Code. It's beautiful, easy to use, and is also widely used in the industry. Try to write some basic programs like printing hello world, writing functions to add some numbers, using if-else statements to print different options, and using a loop to count the number of letters in a word. By far, the most effective way to learn how to code is to build a project. And honestly, that's where the fun is, right? You want to learn how to code so that you can actually do something useful with it. If you're feeling bold, you can try and build something on your own, such as a calculator. But if not, feel free to go ahead and find a project that truly excites you so that you'll stay motivated to learn how to build it to the very end. I've included some links in the descriptions as well. Try to follow the tutorials step by step. If you don't understand something, Google it or ask ChatGPT. Knowing how to use Google and ChatGPT effectively are highly important skills that we need to learn in this day and age because honestly, with all the information out there, it's near impossible to know everything. So you gotta learn how to utilize all these resources effectively. Once you're done with the tutorial, now it's your time to rebuild the project again, but this time without referencing the tutorial. This will make sure that you actually understand what you're coding without blindly following the tutorial. If you get stuck, it's okay, you can go and reference the tutorial again. But the goal here is to be able to rebuild the project as many times as it takes, such that you no longer need to reference the tutorial. At this stage, you want to rebuild the project again, but this time extend or modify it. For example, if you built a calculator, see if you can add a feature that enables advanced functions like a scientific calculator or unit conversions. And if you built a tic-tac-toe game, see if you can track who the winner is each time or add some winning animations. Again, if you are unsure about something, don't forget to Google or ask ChatGPT. It's important to note though that when you use ChatGPT, you don't want to straight out ask it to give you the code for the feature because that way you don't get to actually think through it yourself. Instead, ask it in small steps like, how do I modify the values in this object? And slowly build on from there. By now, you should have some basic understanding of the language and have also built your very first project. Yes, you can write some code, but there's still a lot that you don't know. So what's next? Well, congratulations, it's time for you to level up your learning. Now you want to study the language in depth. Do courses, read documentation, etc. Sites like Udemy and Coursera have a lot of courses on specific languages. They structure the content pretty well and usually have projects that you can code along to. Learning how to read documentation is also an important skill to hone because it can give you really in-depth understanding of the languages. Now, my friend Ray, aka Techie Ray, will be sharing some advice he has as a self-taught programmer.
Hi there, my name is Ray and I'm a proud self-taught programmer from Sydney, Australia. I've been programming for nearly 6 years now and I've got experience in building machine learning apps, web dev and mobile dev. And in fact, I've built and released my own products including a mobile app that can analyze how synchronized your dance moves are, a browser extension that allows lawyers to read legislation more easily, and also a website that can track AI regulations around the world. And internationally, I'm more well known as Techie Ray, being the YouTuber who created the world's first AI system that can analyze K-pop dancers. I wanted to, share my story as to how I got into coding and some tips that I learned along the way. By way of background, I'm actually a lawyer. I practice technology law in Australia. I only went to law school, only have a law degree, so I don't have a formal computer science background. So all of this coding stuff, I picked up on the side as a hobby. I actually already have a video on my own channel which talks about my coding journey and the key lessons I learned. It's very similar to Magdalene's tips, so here are some additional tips that were not already mentioned in my video. Tip number one, focus on the fundamentals, not the syntax. When you first start learning to code, don't get too caught up trying to memorize the keywords or the symbols in a language. Instead, focus on learning the fundamentals, including variables, functions, conditionals, data structures, etc. Actually understand how they work from a conceptual level. For example, how do they work? Why do we need them? How do they affect the behavior of a program? Once you understand these fundamentals deeply, then you can learn any language. The syntax will naturally fall in place, and even if you forget the syntax, can always look them up. So in the grand scheme of things, syntax is not that important. Main thing is fundamentals. Tip number two, once you've mastered the fundamentals, get comfortable with using open source code, including how to use Git. This is especially important if you want to get a job in programming, where it's an industry standard that you know how to find and leverage open source projects. The key word is find. There are many open source projects out there. You have to learn how to find what is a good project from a bad project, what is safe, what's efficient, and what is an appropriate project for you to use in your own project. And as part of that learning, try contributing to an open source project yourself. Not only will you be able to expand your skills even further, but can also tap into a huge community and potentially make new study buddies or friends. And finally, tip number 3, actually have fun with the learning process. Trying to make programming fun so that you feel more motivated and it's a more enjoyable experience for you. Some tips to make programming fun include studying with a friend, or joining a coding club, or this is my personal tip, looking up really cool coding montage videos to get you all hyped up and pumped when you do some coding. So whatever floats your boat, try and make it fun so that it's an enjoyable experience. Feel free to check out my YouTube channel for my projects, tutorials, and guides, as well as my personal website if you want to find out more about me.
So yeah, there you have it. How I would learn how to code if I could start over again. It's very easy to just watch this video and not take any action, so I challenge you to start today. Let me know in the comments below how it goes, and if you like this video, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Stay well, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye!